So today I want to talk about my experience with the Sonos One. And I'm just going to fast forward and spoil the ending for you. I returned it. So I want to talk for a few minutes about why I returned my Sonos One for the Amazon Echo V2. And maybe it's not the reason that you're thinking. So let's take a step back and kind of talk about how we got to this point. And on Black Friday, I went to Best Buy. I had done a bunch of research and decided that the Sonos was the product that I wanted to give my wife. I wanted her to have something that had a lot of volume, something that had good sound quality, and I wanted a digital assistant of some kind in the house. I wanted to be able to ask it questions and get information and just kind of start moving in the direction of home automation. And so it just made sense to start in the central room of the house. So I picked up that device for about $175. It was on sale on Black Friday, and then brought it home, wrapped it up, stuck it under the tree, and I was just absolutely excited about that purchase. So excited, in fact, that that week during Cyber Week, I went and picked up an Amazon Echo Dot, the little guy, on Amazon's webpage. It was $29 and figured, you know what? Hey, kind of get used to using it, kind of learn how these things operate, and we'll be ready to roll when we open up the Sonos. And so we started getting used to Alexa, started asking it questions. I started using it as my alarm in the morning, and I've just been loving using that little device. Well, then Christmas comes, and we open up the Sonos, and I unbox it. And immediately, I was floored by how good the audio quality was on that device. I mean, seriously, one of the best small form factor speakers I've ever heard in my life. So for me, it was one of those like, man, I did not expect to see this come out of this speaker. It has a little audio test so you can make sure you calibrate it to your room correctly. And I mean, it floored me from the time I took it out of the box, from the build quality to the sound quality to the overall functionality. I was just head over heels for this device. Well, we left Christmas morning to visit family and spent basically the rest of the week out of the area of our house. And so we then came back. And when we came back and we started really living with the device and trying to use it in the same way that we used our little Alexa Dot in the bedroom, we just found that it started to fall apart. It wouldn't recognize commands correctly. Especially my wife had a really hard time with it, and the Dot in the bedroom just spot on, whether she's right next to it or not, just constantly is recognizing what she wants and acknowledging all the requests. And so we just said, there's a problem here. And so I started going down the avenue of possibly resetting the device and trying to go down it. But as I started to look through user forums, I realized, no, like the Alexa support in this Sonos One is really not fully baked. And there are a lot of things in it that aren't fully functional yet. Like you can't drop in, you can't make phone calls, you can't do the texting. And some of those things may not be important to you. And they weren't necessarily like deal breakers for me, but being able to engage with the audio assistant the first time, almost every time, and get the information that you need conveniently and quickly is kind of a big deal. And so sitting around the dinner table a few nights after we got back from a Christmas break, my wife and I just kind of talked about it and said, you know, maybe we should just take it back and get the other one. So I pulled out my phone, took a look, and Best Buy actually was running a sale on the Alexa V2, the Echo V2, for $79. So I said, look, I can take the Sonos back and get the Amazon, and we can, you know, basically get back almost $100, which we can use for other things right now, or I can reinvest in some home automation stuff. And so ultimately, we decided for our family and our situation that taking it back was going to be the right course of action. And so I exchanged the two units out. We brought the Amazon Echo V2 back into our house, and I set it up, and honestly, it has been a phenomenal device from the get-go. It operates exactly like the other devices. I can drop into it, which I've already done a couple of times. Just a true story, a little Amazon story for you. I was at the grocery store earlier today, and I called my wife. She wasn't picking up her phone, and so I pulled out my phone with the Alexa app and dropped into the kitchen. And I said, hey, babe, are you in the kitchen? She said, yeah, I'm working. And I said, hey, what was it? And I asked her a question for clarification for the thing that she'd sent me for. And so I got that clarification, terminated the intercom call, and then went about my way in Walmart. And so that was one of those like kind of aha moments, like, wow, this device really works. It really, really does do what I need it to do. Now, if you are looking for a Sonos device with Amazon Echo, well, the Sonos One may not be for you. You can actually buy the less expensive older model and pair it with a Dot if you really want like total integration, or if you're happy with kind of a new system that doesn't have all of its stuff fully baked and you just want to kind of mess with it, then it may be a good choice for you. Or if you just want a central device and sound quality is of paramount importance to you, well, then the Sonos may be what's right for you. But for me, the digital assistant was the one most important thing, and sound quality a very, very close second. And I'm going to tell you, the Echo V2 is not the Sonos, but it's no slouch, and it does sound good. It does have a lot of full, rich volume, and I've been very, very pleased with the audio quality out of the device. Again, not the Sonos, but it's not as big as the Sonos. It's a little more unobtrusive on the kitchen counter. And so I'm really, really happy with the choice that we've made. And so I just wanted to share that with you all because I know a lot of people are buying these devices. And maybe if you're interested in the Amazon ecosystem, maybe this will help you. But either way, I hope you have a wonderful day and we'll be talking to you soon.